Yo, Dan Tricks here, doing tricks from all these fantastic books to make your worlds, well, a little bit more magical. This is the fourth video I'm doing of card control. We're going through all the slides from chapter one, and today I hope these are going to be to your satisfaction, because I think a few of these are really, really good. And we're starting from page 64, and I think we're going to go down to 76. This book may be dated, but let me tell you, the slides in this are absolutely amazing. And if you haven't seen any of the other videos, be sure to check out them. Let's go through all the slides, and I'll see you at the end of the video. Ciao. Okay, so here's another nice one of controlling multiple cards in the deck. We take the four aces in this case, and we'll place them into one, two, three, four different locations in the deck, like so. And what we'll do, if we give the cards a little mix, like that, and a little cut to the table, and now you can see that in fact the four aces have been controlled to the top, or the bottom, if you wish. Okay, so the spectators can shuffle the cards, it doesn't matter. Now, for this one you need two spectators, so could you help me out?
Yeah.
Excellent, could you help me out?
Yeah.
Brilliant. Now, all I want you to do is just to call out stop whenever you wish.
Yeah.
Around about there. Cards, you can see that card there. And would you help me out?
Yeah.
Just say stop. Around about there, you can see the card there. And we have two cards selected in the deck. Now what I'll do is I'll just cut the cards. And well, in fact, we'll give them a little shuffle like this. Like that. The cards mix, and I'll give them another shuffle, like so. Like that. Square the cards up, and in doing so, what you've actually done is you've actually stolen the cards and got them in your palm.
That's bloody good, Dad.
Thanks.
Yeah, excellent.
Cheers. And that is Buckley's double peak location, shuffle and palm on page 65. So check that out. Okay, pay close attention to this one. A spectator can select any card they wish. In this case, it is the Nine of Diamonds. The Nine of Diamonds will lose into the center of the pack. And what I'll do is I'll take the card, I'll give them a mix, make sure they're well and truly shuffled. Like that. And we'll give them a little square up as well. And in doing so, what you've actually done is palmed their selection. And that is Buckley's top palm slide off, page 67. Okay, this is on page 68, and this is Berg's top palm. And unlike the other one, where your thumb is across the top of the pack, this one, your thumb is here on the non-index corner. And what you do is, if a card is selected, say the Queen of Hearts, you control it to the top in any method you wish. And in doing so, what you've done is you've actually palmed their card. Berg's top palm. So the slide off version, you have your thumb on the top, like so, and it slides off when squaring the pack. In Berg's top palm, you have your thumb on the non-index corner, and you just swivel the card off the little finger. It swivels on the thumb over here, and you've palmed the card. Now obviously I'm not going to go through it too much, but check it out in the book, page 68. Now I hope I'm pronouncing this right. The Allerton top palm, Alton top palm, I don't know. Anyway, this is page 69, it's my favourite number. This is basically the same method as Berg's top palm. You have the card on the index corner here, and you actually thumb off cards. However many cards you want to palm, say let's say three, thumb off like that, come up, and again, you've then palmed three cards. So it's using the thumb count, four, five, six, you can use six, and your hand comes up over here. Remember, with palming, you don't want your thumb lifting off the deck. You want to keep that and make out your square in the pack, and that way you have palmed the cards that you acquire. Okay, now this is a really nice one. I think you'll like this. I like this one. It's a really nice technique. Now, a spectator can select any card they wish. They're all different. So they pick the Three of Hearts. The Three of Hearts is placed into the deck, like so. And what we'll do is we'll give the card a little cut and even a shuffle. So, and what I'm going to do is place the cards on the table, and what I'll give the cards a little cut like so, and in doing so, what you've actually done in the cutting process, you've palmed their selection. And that is the one-handed top palm by Judson Cole, page 69.
So here we are for this one. We'll show you the top card like so, which is the Two of Hearts. The Two of Hearts is then drawn onto the deck like that, but in doing so, you've actually palmed the Two of Hearts. Now wait for it, that is actually called palm off the second top card while top card is visibly drawn onto the face. It's a mouthful, page 70. Okay. Now this one allows you to palm off multiple cards using your thumb, just to, so if you want six, go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, push it over with your thumb, so it's, your thumb hides the fact that these cards are further over, and with this hand comes up, over here you come up, square the cards, and you've palmed as many cards as you desire. Page 70, and that is called to palm off the top of the pack an exact number of cards, up to 10. That's another mouthful. Okay, this is another nice method of palming several cards. Say you want to palm, say, four cards, you thumb count, like so, and in doing so, what you do is, placing the pack in your right hand, you've actually palmed the four cards that you require. And because you've got them in your palm like so, you can also place them back into your left hand, and that returns the cards to the top of the deck. And that's another method, and that's called top palm, one of several cards. Check it out if you've got the book. Practice it, get it right, get it really good, unlike me. Okay, here's another really nice card control. You take the deck of cards, fan them out, spectator can select any one they want. Queen of Diamonds, place that back into the deck, and then what you do is you turn it over, and the hands and everything are completely empty. You give the cards a little cut, like so, and that controls their card to the top. And that is the fan location, page 72. Check that one out. Okay, now this is called the fan location amplified. It's the same as the first method, but instead, this time, take the Ten of Hearts, goes into the deck like so, and this time the card is actually controlled, not to the top, but to the bottom. Okay, now this one's rather different, which I think if you've got the book, you should definitely check it out. So, pack of cards, King of Spades selected, any card can be chosen, doesn't matter. And we'll lose that card in the center of the deck, like so. Give it a shuffle. Now, so their card, the King of Spades, has been selected and placed in the centre of the deck. And then what you do is you take these cards, give them a little cut, like so, and in doing that, you've actually turned the King of Spades face up in the centre of the deck. And that is called a novel palm, so be sure to check that out. Okay, here's another nice move you can do. Again, say a card is selected, the Seven of Spades, we'll place it into the deck like so, and mix it up. And what we'll do is we'll show the Five of Hearts. There's the Five of Hearts, and then what you do is place the Five of Hearts face down, and in doing so, it is their selection. And that is called changing a card in the act of turning a card over. That's a long one. Okay, here's another nice method. Card is selected, say the Eight of Hearts, that is then lost into the deck, like so. And we have the King of Hearts. We'll take that King of Hearts from here, and just by throwing it on the table, you can see that in fact it has changed to their selection. And that is the throw change. So what do you think to that? Today, going through all these slides out of this book, and there's some really nice palms there, turning the card over, how to change some cards. I hope I've done them all justice. Obviously, go through the book, be sure to practice them. The fan location's very nice. If you haven't got the book, then, well, you're missing out. So if there's any questions you've got about any of these slides, please leave that in a comment down there, and I'll be sure to get back to you and let you know what I think, what you think, what everybody thinks. So today we've done from page 64 to 76. Maybe I can do it in one video, the rest from here to there. Look at that.
from page 78 to 93. And then chapter 2, Conjuring at the Card Table. Can't wait to show you guys something from that section. If you haven't subscribed, make sure you do. Smash the like button, because I really, really appreciate it, and it'd help my channel to grow. So make sure you do give it a thumbs up. None of this. It doesn't matter, because no one can see that anyway now. I'm the only person that can see it. And make sure, obviously, press that notification bell so you never miss any of my videos. And I also want to leave you with this last little effect. The beginning of this routine is actually from Apocalypse, Volume 1 to 5. The bit at the end, well, it's a bit of a classic. I'm going to put this out as a short as well. So I'll leave you with this. Hope you enjoy it, and I'll see you in the next video. See ya. Okay, now here's something interesting. I'll do this quick for you, because I know that people's concentration spans aren't what it used to be. Now watch. Hands empty, fingers empty. All I've got to do is rub my hands together like so. And look, one, two, and of course, three, and finally, four coins are produced in a rather magical way. Of course, what we can do is take these four coins from here. We can cover each coin like that, and one will travel, and another one will travel, and of course, finally, that coin will travel. But who wants to do that?